patient was a 78 years old hypertensive gentleman on topical medications for chronic angle closure glaucoma, presenting with progressive dimness of vision in both the eyes for 3 months. On examination, his best corrected visual acuity was 6/12. Intraocular pressure was within normal limits in both the eyes. There was grade 4 nuclear sclerosis with posterior subcapsular cataracts in both the eyes. Right eye phacoemulsification with IOL implantation under topical anesthesia was planned. After making 2 side ports and main incision, the VHEX pupil expanding device was implanted. Anterior capsulorhexis was completed, followed by hydrodissection and nuclear rotation. The nucleus was divided using direct vertical chop. Nuclear fragments were emulsified. Cortical aspiration was started, but soon the anterior chamber became very shallow, with iris prolapse through the side ports. Attempts to reposit the iris using viscoelastics failed. Surgery was temporarily stopped. The patient was sent to block room for intravenous mannitol infusion. After 1.5 hours, the surgery was resumed. There was persistent iris prolapse through the side ports. Globe remained hard. Cortical aspiration was difficult due to apposition of the posterior capsule with capsulorhexis margin. There was a high risk of capturing the posterior capsule and causing rent. The fundal glow looked crimson red. Now the goal was to remove the VHEX ring and leave the patient aphakic. Due to high intraocular pressure, removal of the ring was a challenge. Prolapsed iris was reposited and intracameral pilocarpine injected. All incisions were hydrated with the balanced salt solution. Surgery was completed for the day, leaving little cortex in the capsular bag, but without any iatrogenic complication. Five days later, the patient had a vision of 6x18 with aphakic correction and IOP of 23 mm Hg. Fundus revealed choroidal elevation temporal to the macula. D-scan ultrasonography showed temporal choroidal detachment with suprachoroidal hematoma. To conclude, per-operative raised IOP, manifested by the palpable heart globe, corneal edema, repeated iris prolapse and shallowing of anterior chamber may be due to suprachoroidal hemorrhage. Elderly patients with comorbidities, like hypertension, chronic angle closure glaucoma may be at increased risk. A high index of suspicion is needed to diagnose the condition early. Closing the incisions and postponing the remaining steps for another day is the best option. Thank you.